Yes, this is the introduction video, number 000. Telling you what it is all about. And it's about a software product. And momentarily my computer is uploading to YouTube, so it's not very fast. you can see this. My activity monitor. It's sending data, and my modem is having trouble receiving data. What you see here is what you should call a website. It contains YouTube links. This is my face playing guitar, and the number is King of the Lake. And this song is called On Your Own Force. Anyway, this is a website. And you have links. This is a button. And this text is generated. This date comes from the system. An ISO date was entered by me, and the system makes 20 March of it. This is not created using Apache or PHP. This output is created by a C program, old school plain C. Now I'll take another example. This is the brouwerij, we say in Holland. There they make beer. And they also make mede, which is an alcoholic beverage. Made of honey. And for this firm, it's a very lovely people. I have set up and we are working on it together. You're looking at testing data in progress. And what I will now ask for are the mutations of stock. Once again, the numbers do not matter. It's about how it looks like. This report you can print out using a landscape. So if you do a print, ask for this option. Make it landscape. And here you can see per product. This product is amber mout. It's something you need for your beer. This is the amount that they had at the beginning of the year. And this was the value. You can see that this pro forma values. This is the amount that was used for production. And this is the amount in euros. This is the amount that was sold. The debtors are the ones that you receive money from. This is the amount that was purchased. And this was the amount that was used. And all these columns produce a end stock. A stock by the end of this year, because the selection that I have chosen was all of 2016. And there we have the average VVP, which is the ratio by which the stock is valued. In Dutch it's called vaste verrekenprijs. Prijs is price, and verreken means the account value. So now you have seen two examples of what you can do with PIX. And I will show you a last one. This is these are friends, and they play football. We call that football, and in English it's called soccer. And this will take some time to load. Pictures are moving in. This community of soccer players, very multicultural people, they have had an election, and people were asked to vote for either Erik de Vos, Michel Adriaans, Claudia Perlé of Belinda Dijkstra. And here you can see the number of votes, and that's the percentage. It boils down to the fact that about 10% of all the members have brought out their vote. But then again, it's still something. And here what you see is, it looks like a normal website. But it is not a normal website. Because this software works completely independent of whatever proprietary software you can imagine. Well, this you can make using PHP, I believe that. But to implement a voting machine, then you have to use whatever programmer is stuff. You cannot do it yourself. And in PX you can do that. And in PX you can have production orders, meaning you have produced stuff. Days a month, meaning this month. So, and that is a production order. We're still starting up, the VVP is not yet filled in here. We're working on that. But here you can see that they have made fusten. It's a vat. A vat of beer. And therefore they used a batch of beer. They produced 10 fusten. Barrels, that's the word. 10 barrels were produced using 200 liters of this batch. And you have very complicated recipes. Let me look at this one. Yes, this is a correct one. This looks correct. We have 200 produced of this batch. And for this we have used, and this is with a minus. This total is not so useful because it's a it's not useful. It should be missing, but it's there. It's due to the general functionality of this object that you are looking at right now. These are the prices by which they are valued in the accounting system, and this is the amount. And you can see that the total of this amount is zero, which is correct. Because the value of this product, this amount, is based on the opposite of the values below here. That's the idea of a production administration. And it's all to, because they are producing beer, and the government wants to have accijns. It's a special kind of tax. And the government has a right. And PX can help you with taking care of your administration. And for the last part for this demo, I will log in to a live PX server.
Well, this is broadcast number 2.
Sorry for that. And I will just log into one of our, let's take the server of that we were just looking at. And that was this of the football club. I will just log in using the normal privileges. Usually, I do this. Oh no. Bash. But I won't do that now. I will move over to the PX directory. And these are the contents. And I will ask for a view in the current log directory. I'm sorry. Not my best typing day. Yeah, the machine is very slow. Yes. And it should be running all the time. And if I now log into, I will do something. I will make this smaller. And I'll just, what shall I do? I'm going for this button. Now watch the lower end of the screen. I will make it a little. Well, there's another user busy right now. We can see that. Huh? I'll wait for a moment of silence and then I will fire it. And that is me. Yes. And that is the page that I wanted to see. Okay, it's now very silent. And now I'll go for this. That one, and then it will run again. And you can use this product as a user, and you can use this product as a programmer. And it's very safe and secure. And you can build whatever information system you would like. There is really no end to the possibilities. And this software also runs on a banana pi or a Raspberry Pi or whatever as a server. And about this product, I already published 2 broadcasts with the details. Interesting stuff for people who would like to control their own computer. Okay, let me quit this. Let me have a look at the table of processes. And here you can see that PX is running. It's taking 21% of the memory, about 5% of the CPU. And the total memory is 2 gigabytes. So it's 21% of 2 gigabytes is 400 megabytes, 500 megabytes, 600 megabytes. You need some megabytes to run PX. And this runs on a single machine. Virtually speaking, it are 4 machines. We have 4 processors. and each processor is dedicated to one machine. But PICs can really good handling, can really good handle multiple processors. It will really fire them up. You might even say that PX is ready for the moment that people will have computers with 1K processor power, meaning 1024 processors. How many K of processors do you have? And it is built for those times ahead. But it will run with the software threading also. It is now running with software threads because it only has one processor for in this live environment. And it uses software threads to do the multitasking handling. But it's better to have it with multiple threads, really multiple processors. Now that's about it for the short introduction. And the first broadcast handles about the PX directory. This will take you about an hour, and the second broadcast goes deeper into this directory, and it's the resource directory, which also contains the source. It's a very interesting concept. And for the last, I will now, this is the live server. Characters are a bit small, but let me try. Yes, I can enlarge this. Yeah, okay. Yeah, this is the home directory of this live server. Yep. And now I will move over to the resource that yep. Please bear with me, it's a bit slow. And here you can find the source code. Meaning, if there is a PIX server, PX server, and it has a problem or a wish, the users want something different, then the px.resource directory contains the source code. So here I have introduced a very interesting legal problem. Namely, the source code is a part of the system. PIX is not necessarily meant to be open source, because authors have to be paid for their work. What else is the use of writing a piece of software? But in this special case, I have to publish the code just for business continuity. What do you call it? Yeah, continuity. That every server will remain to work. So source codes, the source code files, the group of those files, and all the information needed to adjust, to repair, to whatever, expand, resides on the same machine where PX runs. Because it needs the files. That's it. So I hope that you want to learn more about this very interesting product. which has taken me, I started this project in 1988, which is some years ago. The days in which I had more hair. But it really worked out fine. And it's running very efficiently, and you can build whatever system with it that you would like. So I hope that I will speak to you again, that you will listen to me again in the broadcast. Tschüss for now.